Hello and Namaste. I'm back after a gap of 1 month. I traveled extensively in December. I visited the Subramanya Swami temple in Tiruchendur recently. It is a 1,000-year-old temple with many hidden wonders. Like many of our ancient temples, its myths and legends extend to the present day. Sometimes I feel it is implicit in the word we use for temples that are in active worship. We call them living temples because their stories too have a life of their own and keep on growing. Situated in the shore of Gulf of Mannar, the surging tides of the sea kiss the temple walls. The main sanctum is less than 200 feet from the shore. I shot this video when I was there. Notice how the temple seems to be sitting on the waves. Before entering the temple, the pilgrims take a dip in the sea. How did this temple came to be situated here? Usually, Muruga temples are built on hills. Out of the 6 primary temples for Lord Muruga called the Arupadai Veedar, Tiruchendur is the only one which is not on a hill but on the seashore. The legend has it that the Devas were being tormented by an asura called Surapadman. Lord Muruga, who is the general of the army of Devas, came down from Kailash to the south to fight the asura. He is said to have camped at Tiruchendur along with his army, and he wanted to worship his father before the battle. It is believed that the celestial architect Maya himself constructed this temple for Shiva in the seafront, and Muruga worshipped his father here. The Shivalingams which Muruga worshipped is still there in the temple today, behind the statue of Subramanya Swami. After worshipping Shiva here, Muruga waged a fierce battle with Surapadman and defeated him. It lasted for 6 days, by the end of which Lord Muruga's soldiers were exhausted and thirsty. It is said that Lord Muruga lifted his weapon, the Velayudham, and thrust it in the ground. Fresh water came gushing out of the spot and formed a well. Lord Muruga's soldiers quenched their thirst with this water. Even today, you can find a well at this spot. Unfortunately, I could not see the well because it was closed due to COVID restrictions. It is called Nari Kinaru. It is a curious structure with 2 wells, one within the other. There is an outer well about 14 square feet in dimension and a smaller well within it, which is about 1 square feet. The larger well has salty water, possibly because of the proximity to the sea. In fact, all the wells in the vicinity have salty water. The smaller well within it has crystal clear water and it's sweet tasting. It is a mystery how this well alone has such crystal clear and drinkable water. It is believed to be a blessing of Lord Varuna, the god of the oceans and water bodies, who was very grateful to Muruga for defeating the demon who was tormenting him and his fellow Devas. The legend says that Lord Varuna made a promise to Lord Muruga that his sea water would never breach the shore and enter his temple. This story is as old as the temple itself, over 1,000 years old. Let us now fast forward to the year 2004, the year when a devastating tsunami struck the Indian Ocean. The entire coast of Tamil Nadu was devastated by the tsunami. The small town of Tiruchendur too was not spared. But there was one place where the water did not enter. You guessed it right. Not a drop of seawater entered the temple. This indeed feels like a miracle, considering the proximity of the temple to the sea. The Tiruchendur bus stop, which is only 2 kilometers away, was inundated too. This story was doing the rounds during tsunami, and I remember reading about it. People said that Varuna kept his promise to Lord Muruga, and this demonstrated the divine power of the deity. A couple of scientific explanations were also provided for this phenomenon. One explanation was that Tiruchendur is in the shadow of Sri Lanka, so to speak. If you look at a map, a tsunami approaching India from Indonesia will hit Sri Lanka first. So it was Sri Lanka which bore the brunt of the tsunami, and Tiruchendur was therefore spared. This does not adequately explain how the other parts of Tiruchendur, like the bus stop and Jeevanagar, were inundated. Another explanation is that the temple is situated on a small cliff-like structure overlooking the sea. This elevation protected the temple. It appears that this spot was specifically chosen for this reason. If the temple was situated a little to the south of its current location, it would have been inundated. If this is true, it makes you wonder about the scientific wisdom of our ancients, who 1,000 years ago could identify a small piece of land in the vast stretch of the coastline that would not be inundated by the sea. It also shows the confidence they had in their knowledge to locate the temple so close to the ocean. Whichever way you look at it, it is mind-blowing. That's it from me this week. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe and press the bell icon for reminders. If you like the story, please pass it on to like-minded people. Until next time, Namaste.